In this video, we are going to learn how to fix white balance in Lightroom. Sometimes in your images, you might have observed color cast, or maybe they're a little bit bluish or yellowish or greenish or a little bit magenta. In this video, I'm going to share with you two simple tricks, two simple methods that can easily get your color casts out of the way and bring back true colors to your images. Fixing your white balance is one of the first steps that you do before going further into editing your image. So without any further ado, let's get started. Hey there, this is Unmesh, and finally we are in the develop module. Remember in previous videos we were working in library module organizing our images? That can be boring, but this is the most interesting part. We are going to edit our images in develop module. Let's go back to the film days. Let me explain what develop module is. Back in the film days, you had your negatives and you used to give your negatives to get it developed, right? That's the same with digital imaging today. When you click an image in raw format, it's a raw image. You need to develop it. You cannot just directly give it to your client unless they require it in RAW, or you cannot directly post it in social media. You need to process it, and the processing can be done by developing, and the developing can be done in Lightroom or any other software that you might be using. So the develop module is all about developing your digital negative images. Yes, RAW images are also called digital negatives. The first step into editing your images is to fix the white balance. Set the white balance correctly. Now, what is white balance? If you want to know what exactly white balance is in scientific terms, Tony Northrup has an amazing video explaining the science behind white balance and color temperatures and all of that. But in this video, I'm going to simply teach you how to set the white balance right. Now, what is fixing white balance? Well, fixing the white balance is nothing but telling the camera or Lightroom or any other software that you're using which color to consider white. For example, I'm wearing a white shirt. This is a black shirt, but let's take for an example, I'm wearing a white shirt. And now when I click a picture from a camera, it gives it a bluish tint. Now, I tell my computer or the software to consider this color as white, and accordingly, it gives color to everything else in the room. Simply, setting white balance is telling the camera or the computer what they should consider white. It's essential to note that white exactly doesn't mean it has to be completely bright white. It can be gray. It just has to be a neutral color. So let's get back into Lightroom in the develop module. So here I am in Lightroom in library module, and I have some examples for you to set the white balance. To go to the develop module, you can just click and go to the develop module, or what you can do, you can press D, D for develop, develop module. So press D, you're in the develop module. So the basic panel is the panel in which we will do 90% of our editing. So this is the basic panel which has the white balance, the tone, and the presence. It is the place where we edit our images 90%, and then we finish it off in other panels. So this is the basic panel, and the adjustments that you make in this panel is global. You cannot selectively, suppose you want to make the face a little bit brighter. You cannot do that in basic panel. Basic panel is for global adjustments. Whatever you change in the basic panel changes throughout the image. For this editing, what I want you to do, tuck this right in. Why? I'm going to tell you why. Now, the first way to set the white balance is the eyedropper tool. So select the eyedropper tool and click on a place where you think it must have been gray. As you can see in this image, it's a blue cast due to the blue light that we had in the stage. We shouldn't have that light. That's giving it a blue cast. Now, what if I want to remove this blue cast? So pick the eyedropper tool, which I've already picked. Click on a place which should have been gray according to you. Now, this area should have been gray. Click it. Boom. You have the original color. That's as simple as ABC. Now, sometimes when you're picking in this thing, this kind of box that you have can be distracting. So you can just unmark this and it will be gone. Now, let's go back, let's go undo. Now, why did I ask you to tug this out? Why did I ask you to get this out and see the navigation? When you select the eyedropper tool, and when you move the eyedropper tool around, you just look here, look at the navigator. Look at what happens to the image when I move around the eyedropper tool. It changes, right? It changes. So suppose you want to click here, but before clicking, you have a preview that if you click here, your image will look like this. If you click here, your image will look like this. If you click here, your images will look like the one which is in the navigator. If you click here, it will look like that. So you get a preview of if you click there, what will happen. So as this is a steel stand, it had to be gray. And when you move the mouse around here, it gives you the perfect colors in the preview in the navigator. Just click here and you have the original colors. Let's look at another example. So I have another image here. And also in this image, we can go to the develop module and click around here. And we have the original color in just one click. But what if you don't have an area which should have been gray? Now, let's tuck it in and let's open this image. Now, as you can see, this has a bluish tint. And suppose there is no area which should have been gray. What do you do then? Let's go to the develop module. To do that, remember, press D. We are in the develop module. Now let's tuck it in. And if you want to make it look more yellowish, drag it to the right. If you want to make it look bluish, drag it to the left. It's that simple. Don't worry about color temperatures. Don't worry about all that science. If you want it to look yellow, to the right. If you want it to look blue, to the left. Now, I think for this image, this is the right area to be. Now, if you want it to look more greenish, to the left. If you want it to look more magenta-ish, to the right. Now, this is the tint, and the above one is the temperature. Just don't worry about what it says. Left, green, right, magenta. So this seems to be perfect for me. Now, I think this image is a little bit darker, so let's make it a little bit brighter. And voila, it's ready. Also, I'm going to tell you a bonus way to set your white balance. So let's do it in this image. Now first, to reset white balance, this is very essential. To reset any setting, any slider, you just have to double click on the slider and it's reset to it, resets to its original position. Now let's click on the other slider too and it's reset. Now, to reset, suppose you have gone haywire and you don't have the time to reset on one slider one at a time, all you can do is double click on the WB and it's all reset. Now, let's try a new way of setting the white balance. So as you click here, you have a lot of presets that you can use to set the white balance. You can try one by one what works for you, what doesn't work for you. There are a lot of presets that you can use. For me, I think for cloudy works best. Now, there's a catch here. You can use the presets extremely easy to use. But if you're importing a JPEG image, a JPG image, instead of a RAW image, then you won't have these options. You won't have these presets. Plus, in JPEG, your white balance will be centered in both temperature and tint, unlike in RAW, where we have the white balance set to the value in which the camera actually took the picture. But still, in JPEG, you can move the sliders to the right or to the left and adjust the white balance accordingly. So that's how you fix white balance in Lightroom. That's all for today. If you love the video, like it. If you dislike the video, dislike it. But make sure you hit the subscribe button to get more videos like this in future. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.